right, this is something new. Welcome everyone to a vlog style video, and just title implies. Today's video will be on a cutting style video at my barber, and I'm on the way to my barber right now. I fully degreased last night, and I have nothing in my hair but just some Vitalis hair tonic. And First of all, I need to say that if you go to your barber, you need to degrease. It's just a nuisance for your barber to cut your hair if it's just full on greasy, you still have any remaining pomade or buildup in there. And I'm sorry for the noise because I'm just like walking around the city center, obviously. I'm on my way to my barber right now. So basically, I recommend that your hair would be a little semi-styled, so it can serve as a guide for your barber to cut your hair a lot easier. So that's why I have a little bit of hair tonic in there. I wouldn't really recommend anything too greasy, which is why I prefer using an alcohol or water-based tonic instead of an oil-based tonic right now, and usually before I go to my barber. But in any case, if you're not able to degrease, you don't even have the time to, then I would strongly recommend that you actually pour in a water or alcohol-based tonic in your hair to just make sure your hair is reactivated, and it would just be a lot easier for your barber to style it instead of just coming in with straight greasy hair. Because even with pomade in your hair, just putting some of these tonics in there would just help break it down and make it a lot easier to manipulate. With that being said, I mentioned something about having your hair semi-styled. I'm not long for this. Right, just people being racist right now. Ignore the background. So, what was I going to say earlier? Anyway, making sure that your hair is just semi-styled. So for that, you wouldn't want to overstyle your hair with a greasy product like an oil-based pomade. But just, I wouldn't even recommend a hair cream like Brill Cream either, but just try to find a not-so-greasy one like Brisk, for example. And basically, styling your hair with just a tonic before going to the barber with just nothing in it, but just tonic would be a kind of ideal. So that just make sure your hair is parted already like mine is, and just look home to the side. Just make sure you do something with it, but not too much, so it can serve as a guide for your barber, so that he kind of knows what you actually do want. And later at the barber, I'll show exactly what I normally say to my barber to get the haircut I desire. So yeah, I'll see you then. All right, so we're getting really close to the barbershop right now, and here it is. This is where I get my haircut. It's called So 50s. And it's not just a traditional barbershop specializing in 1950s haircuts, but also it is a fashion store focused on rockabilly clothing, as well as a pomade shop. But it mainly specializes in women's and pinup clothing more than the men's article of clothing. But yeah. Here we go. Hi, Raymond.
Hey.
Yeah. There's the shop itself. Okay, so right now I'm sat down at the barber's chair, and this is my barber, Raymond. And he founded the shop with his wife, Marlies, a couple of years ago. There's a backstory to that. We'll talk more about that later. But anyway, the one thing I recommend when you walk into a barber shop and let your barber know what you want, it's best to show a picture. Well, sure, you can go ahead and give some terms such as I want an executive contour with a lower mid taper, but never ever use the words little at the top, because your definition of little at the top may differ to barbers. So basically your barber might take a lot of the top when you actually only mean, for example, say half an inch, and one barber's definition of a little off the top may be different from others. Never ever use a phrase. You can go ahead and use some terms such as a number two taper, for example, but that's only if you know what you're doing. I personally don't use these terms because those numbers can even vary internationally. North America, Europe, the numbers can actually differ per clipper, so I don't use numbers. So every time, always show a picture of the hairstyle you want. You can look on the internet. Instagram is one of the best examples. Look at some barber accounts on Instagram for the hairstyle you want. Or it's best to actually go ahead, if you have a haircut you like and you had before, you can go ahead and scroll a gallery and show it to your barber. And I show my barber these pictures over here, and that's what I show every time. And make sure, if you have a really good haircut, always document it so you can use it as a reference for the next time. So, Raymond, go ahead and do your thing.
We'll make this time.
And we have some great 50s music in the background as well, such as Paul Anka. I really hope YouTube doesn't take this down due to copyright issues.
Well, first you can put your glasses on.
Right.
Yeah.
In case you guys want to know what my hairstyle is called, you can call it a vintage sideboard, but it's actually mainly referred to as an executive contour. It's best if it's tapered. For a more greaser twist to it, you can twist it up with a ducktail as well, or a duck's ass. But personally, I don't do duck's asses because they really don't suit my hair type, and it just doesn't work. So I always go for a really classy taper.
Good choice.
Yeah.
We heard it's a good choice.
Thanks. So Raymond, I think it would be great if you, for each step you do, you can explain to the audience what exactly you're doing and why you do it. So that would be nice.
You're asking something, right?
Yeah.
First, I take the clipper, put a size 3 on it. And first do the side parts and the back part. The most important thing is to build up a haircut.
That means I think for this we can just go ahead and rotate so you can show the right there. So Raymond, why exactly did you start this shop over here? What's the backstory behind it?
The short of the backstory is Elvis. With Elvis, everything started.
Nice. Yeah.
I was 8 years old and I became an Elvis fan. And from then on, first day off, it all started. I come from a hairdresser family. We're all barbers.
Elvis is the man. We all started out, quite a lot of us in the Rockville community do indeed start from Elvis. As I myself did start with Elvis as well, but to be fair, we can actually say that probably the Beatles are the one that inspired me, because I used to be a huge Beatles fan when I started out with all vintage stuff, and I decided to find out why the Beatles are so great, where their influence is, and among them is Elvis Presley, Buddy Holly, Little Richard, so I decided to go search them up, and the next thing I know, I also listen to a lot of Elvis music, and I've gotten more and more into the 50s.
Yeah. And Elvis was the main artist. For you.
So how would you describe the current rockabilly scene and traditional haircuts in general in this city and or even country? So let's just start with your opinion on the rockabilly scene in this country, in the Netherlands.
It could be more. It is big, but it could be more. For instance, in the big cities, that's why we are so busy to take the hair to the smaller cities like Enschede. It's very important to keep rock and roll and rockabilly alive.
Yes, I do agree. Mainly the rockabilly scene in the Netherlands is most active around the Rotterdam area. Little cities surrounding it, such as Dordrecht and Papendrecht, for example. And in Eindhoven, there's still quite a following as well. That's around the center of the Netherlands, I believe. And however, right here in the east of the Netherlands, like in the cities of Enschede, I barely know about any rockabilly scene going on here. And so for Enschede, we actually do have this barbershop over here, thanks to you. And recently, we have that bar that just opened last December, which I attended the opening. So that's a really great start.
Yeah.
It's mostly, the scene is mostly active in the west. Most of my Dutch rockabilly friends are from the west as well. But right here in the east, there's barely anything. But I'm glad that we're all starting out from here.
Yeah. Do you meet some rockabilly fans already here in Amsterdam?
Besides Luke Christoffel.
Yeah.
He's like the first guy I actually like ran into. So basically, Luke Christoffel, he's a musician, and he's also really big into the rock and roll rockabilly style as well, and he puts his own modern twist to it as well. So one day we actually bumped into each other in Christmas Eve, and we got to know each other, and we got along pretty quickly.
Yeah, that was a great experience, right? To meet such people.
Yes. And of course, in that bar, whenever there are events going on, such as Ruben and Tin Stars, they actually came here for the opening. There are quite a lot of rockabilly fans gathering here in the bar.
Yeah.
So that's another great way to meet other rockabilly fans from the city and the country.
Yeah. We have the owner of Crossroads is already here.
All right, yeah. The owner of Crossroads, his name is Dion, and apparently he just stopped in the. He's talking right now to Marlies, Raymond's wife, which is really awesome.
Yeah.
Didn't expect that.
Maybe when he has some time, he comes over and talk to us, right? Explains
exactly.
How it works in the Crossroads Cafe.
Crossroads, by the way, is the name of the bar, the cafe. 1950s rock and roll themed. It's mainly a blues and rockabilly bar, but we also do have some general rock acts performing there as well, not just blues and rockabilly. Do you see the art of traditional barbering surviving here in this city? What do you think about the current art of traditional barbering right now?
Yes, I'm not trying it. It's all depends on the experience. It's all about the experience. When you grew up with a barber and everything, it's very important. You don't go to school and learn it. Yeah, it's a feeling. It's a different way of life.
That's Dion right over there. So.
Hi. He's filming now for YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
Have a good one.
Yeah, yeah.
And you?
Goedjes aan Linda.
Ja, doe.
En ja, morgen. Doei. Fijne weekend, hè. Dank je.
Now, I actually once heard from another barber around here that there are a lot of younger people trying to open up their own barbershop. They just go and read something online or just a couple of books, and then they open their own little barbershop down in the garage and invite their friends over and, you know, test them out of them. But all they know how to do is really just fades, and they can't even give a proper fade. Because nowadays, like in the modern barber scene, what most people seem to care about is just fades and undercuts. I mean, the art of taper grading and just traditional haircuts in general, I wouldn't say it's dying, but we saw some kind of resurgence in the early 2010s with the pomade scene being more popular again, which is a great thing. And with barbershops like Scorum and Rotterdam just bringing back up, that's super awesome. But still, right now in the city, there are quite a lot of young people who are not trying to get into modern barbering and not so much in traditional barbering. And this is just probably the only barbershop right here in Enschede that really does super traditional haircuts, which is why this is my go-to place. I'm just really, really lucky that there's something like this right here.
Great, man. Great to hear.
And also, sorry?
So we do our best.
Yes, indeed. And so another really great thing about going to a barbershop is that you kind of build the chemistry between you and your barber. So normally, like a good barber and his client always have an engaging conversation with each other. And most of the time, Raymond and I, we like to engage in really stimulating conversations, such as this. You saw like I'm rolling in this video, for example. But if I don't really feel like it, if I'm a little tired, I just tend to shut up. But most of the time, when we try to strike a conversation, I just do it. And that's great thing about barbershops. You tend to have a great discussion with your barber while you have a haircut.
He's talking a lot. He's talking a lot.
You gotta get something for the audience.
And maybe we'll start, eh?
Yes.
My wife should be in the film also. Yeah, you already did? How long has it been to get a haircut?
A month, actually.
Yeah?
Right, and that's something I really need to address, because I had a question about that on one of my YouTube comments earlier. So he asked me how often I get my haircut.
Yeah.
And I usually get it like after, usually once a month, usually at the end of the month. But I'm at longest, probably 1.5 months. But usually I do it at the end of the month. So right now you're cleaning up the nape area or something?
Yeah. Make the lines really sharp. Clean it up.
So where do you normally order your pomades from?
Mostly I come from Germany.
I'm guessing the pomada shop at DE, which has their headquarters in Munich.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, I do recognize the products are really similar, especially you do have a lot of Dapper Dan products here, which are made by the, established by the pomada shop itself, so it really is no surprise.
Dapper Dan is best. What do you like, Breezy? Homemade?
I do agree that Dapper Dan is one of the best factory-made medium hold pomades.
Yeah.
I normally go for the homebrews, but Dapper Dan is just one of the best store-bought factory-made mediums.
We always use the soft or medium?
Yeah, that's the softest medium hold.
Yeah? I'll take a nice lotion.
So this right here is what really separates a barbershop from a salon, the hair tonic. This is just what really defines the art of traditional barbering. You really can't really complete this art without the hair tonic itself. It just really preps your hair for the styling later on.
Very, very important.
Oh yeah, and also I forgot to mention, I believe we can cut the top a little bit just by half an inch. So normally I do have the top maintained as well, but I would have it cut by not more than half an inch during each cut so that it still can be styled. And also a good barber would know where your cowlick areas are. As for me, my cowlick area lies around the back of my crown, like right over here. And so my barber knows already not to really touch that area too much. So what hair tonic was that? Was it the Ed Pinod or
which one I recommend?
The one you just put on me. That's from the Pinod, right? Or it's one of the yeah, I'm not really sure if it's familiar though.
It's not grease. Not grease lotion.
Ah.
It's a new smell. I never had it before. It's very classic. It's very nice. It's a nice way to cut your hair. With the tonic in it.
That particular tonic, I couldn't really see what it is without my glass on, but it does indeed look really, really familiar though. I've seen it online. Not too familiar with it, however.
I have something that you are not familiar with. Hey, eh?
The use of the blow dryer, what's the purpose behind it?
Always to remove this small hair from your out of your hair and to look at the shape is it already good. Now I got it further. Look over there, it's alright.
So what exactly is this?
It's a shaving oil.
Ah.
It can help you size the areas
sideburns.
And the product you used here was the Dapper Dan shaving oil.
Yeah. It smells so good.
I agree.
Now we take the Dapper Dan, medium hole.
You just can't walk out of a barbershop without pomade.
Nope. Nope. And always work it in through the ears.
So what exactly do you spray in the brush? Is it top powder?
Top powder, yeah. To remove all the... Here they are left, small ones. To dry the skin a little bit. It moves better. It's nice, fresh. Smells good. Finishing touch.
Aftershave.
Aftershave. On that right here.
Is that the blue or the green?
The blue one. Yeah. If you want, you can do your glasses on.
Sure.
Let me show you that.
Yeah. Yeah.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay. I believe we can show the final result as well.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. Bring the camera right front. Okay. So this is the final result here. Okay, I believe you can show the...
To the back.
All right. Right. Okay. Thanks so much for the haircut. Right.
No,
and if you guys do enjoy this video,
pleasure.
Please. Yeah.
Okay.
And if you guys do enjoy this video, please leave a like, comment, subscribe to this channel, click the bell icon to never miss a single upload of the Squinty Show, and I'll see you next time on the Squinty Show.